Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're getting ready to go here. This is a six and under. And you've got C. Perez. She's in the turquoise top versus Deborah Rogers. We watched her play in the Scots in an earlier match. So I take it this is on the one loss side. This is a race to five. BCA ball, we're Casino del Sol. This is C. Perez playing, shooting right now. She's got an open table. And we're Casino del Sol in Tucson, Arizona. This is the 2015 Tucson warm-ups. Coming up, we have the Southwest Regional, as you just saw on the screen. She's going to establish stripes. Now, she played pretty strong. I watched her play in the Scotch doubles. And we don't have our ratings up yet. Maybe that we don't have enough data for them. We'll see if they come up in just a little bit. Off the rail. I want to bounce it off the rail. Looks like she's stroking the ball a little tentative. Someone wanted to just hit that ball and kind of come off that rail to about the middle of the table for this next shot. You don't want 6 feet of distance on a 7 foot table. You'd like to have your shots within 3 feet. Distance between the cue ball and the object ball. Ideally, it would be about 2 or 3 feet. Harder to miss shots that way when there's distance involved. If you don't hit the ball quite right, you can deflect off to the side. Several things can happen that aren't advantageous. Or you can just miss because your stroke isn't quite as straight as you think it is. Nice shot by Deborah. Nice straight shot down the rail. Same shot again on the seven. She could look to shoot this in the side and come up and break up the two balls that are in the middle of the table. Yeah, she's going to draw into them. I don't like that because she can scratch off the 14. Oh, she didn't play it in the side. She played it in the corner. Never mind. My mistake. Again to the side pocket with a two, then probably playing the one. Negotiate the four after it. She's going to have to bounce it off the rail here. Deborah's a shot maker. She likes to just shoot the ball and sequence what comes up next. She doesn't develop the table. She doesn't develop her shape. If it's there, she takes advantage of it. And if it's not, well, then she just finds something else to do. Here's your percentages. We got them up. According to the Fargo ratings, Deborah Rogers has a 64% chance of winning this match with the data that's been input to Fargo ratings. C. Perez has a 36% chance. We're going to see how this works. She called a safe. I guess she called a safe. You pocketed the ball. C's back at the table. Now keep in mind that this Fargo rating is only as accurate as the data that's been inputted One of the things they're doing for Arizona, since there's established rating system, and it's like 5 through 10, 5 being the lowest, 10 being the highest, other than the pro players, is that if a person doesn't have any established games in the Fargo rating, like they have never played BCA, they don't have any tournament games that they can, they've captured in that data, if you're a 7 or an 8, you're somewhere, they'll assign a certain value to that in the vicinity of, you know, 500 points, 400 points, or percentages, 400, 500, your point value, and depending on the ratings assigned accordingly, which would bring into play, into the rating system, would bring in the current Arizona rating for the players, established players in Arizona. These matches will be available on YouTube at the CSI, YouTube CSI, and for viewing probably in a couple of weeks as they get uploaded after, you know, the tournament's over and time permits. They'll get uploaded in a, you know, orderly fashion and be able to view them on there. Ozzy was showing me quite a few tournaments of the pros and how many views they've had. I mean, some of these tournaments have had, you know, thousands of views, and they've only been on the site, on YouTube, a month, month and a half. So it's a good tool, along with quite a few others on YouTube there that CSI has, instructional videos, podcasts, things of that nature, to help build your game. We're still on the first game in a race to 5. You can see the player's name. C. Perez is at the table right now. According to the Fargo rating, she has about a 36% chance of winning this match. Yet they're both rated 6s. We had a late start in this match due to a hold up with the Scotch doubles. So apologizing for the late start. This match, they've been taking about an hour. Your next match is at 7 o'clock, which the men's singles start. And then the match after that will be at 9 o'clock, which will be the finals of the Scotch doubles. Coming up after this match, you've got Steve Lillis versus Trace Kane. That'll be a great match for you to watch, and you'll see some skilled play from both players. Steve Lillis is a master player. Trace Kane is an advanced player. So Steve will be getting the game on the wire Steve will be giving Trace a game on the wire, where Steve will go to 6. I believe Trace will go to 7. Did I get that wrong? Steve will go to 6, Trace will go to 5. Sorry. Actually, it might be 7-6. Since they both go up a game, master players go up 2 games from the open 5, and the advanced players go up 1 game. Well, if she makes a good shot here and hold the cue ball down, she might be able to play that other stripe that's next to the 8 in the side pocket. And she did. She did a beautiful job of getting the cue ball there. Wow. Pretty job. Stunned it right over, caught the rail, came in close to the work. Maybe a little too close. She might have been a little bit better off if she was a few inches further away. She'll probably be able to see the angle better and see that she's in danger of scratching in that lower right-hand corner pocket. Score is 0-0. This is the first game of a race to 5. She's going to bank it. pretty well done. Had she made the ball, she'd have to do the same thing with the eight, with less of an angle. But she's left Deborah in a precarious position. She's up over a ball on this, she throws to the back of the six, top of the six. And she's going to attempt the four ball in the corner pocket. She can only strike the right side of the cue ball. Well, she's made it. She strike the pretty much the right height part of it to make this four. And she, first and foremost, moved the six, but she can just leave there. This is up to her opponent whether she wants to move it back or replace it or leave it there. Just leave it there. I thought so. That gives her more distance between the eight ball and the six. It's not her mistake. It's her opponent's. She'll just leave the ball there. It gives her more room to play position with. And she's aiming the ball. If she just puts a little draw on this ball, she should come over perfect for this eight ball. It's a small stun to the lower left side. Close to that five ball. Don't scratch. Oh, that's about where she wanted to be. Maybe just a little better than that. Had she hit it at the angle that she would have made the ball, that cue ball would be down closer to the diamond below the side pocket. Would have had much better shape position on the eight, even though that's very good. But this leaves Deborah very nice position. So you can start with the four ball, the one ball, the five ball, and the six ball. Now, had she started with the four ball, she'd be much better off than where she is now. But she still has the five to recover. And she'll probably just roll this in and then play the ball by the eight and then the four. And it is. Now, from what I've seen of Deborah's stroke, she doesn't have the stroke to get the cue ball back for the eight that I've seen. We'll see what she does here. Well, she's going to attempt to draw the ball back. Well, looks like she stunned it down, gave herself more distance than she needed to. And now getting the ball back is, I'm going to say, virtually impossible. The way I've seen her stroke the ball. She's going to fall, but is she trying to draw this ball? She is. She'll be lucky to stop it. She's going to push through it. Oh, she's going to slow roll it. Well, she's actually taking a huge risk. She's trying to make the ball. Left herself a low percentage shot on the eight, but she's left her opponent a longer, almost straight in shot. If she pockets this ball, she's going to have position on the eight. Especially if she pockets it with good speed, which she has been doing with other shots, so I don't foresee anything different from here than this. Just make the ball, she'll have a nice position on the eight. But she missed it. Now, if it doesn't get into it, it doesn't matter. She has to get to the four. Now, she wants to hit the right side of this ball, thin, and come straight down, just about to where the side pocket, just past the side pocket. You're going to use dead center? Oh, that's not past the side pocket. That's way past the side pocket, and that's in the corner pocket. Right out of the jaws, into the mouth of Road to 600. Tough shot here. Good thing is she probably leaves a low percentage shot if she misses the eight. Tough shot, but she's made tough shots. She made it. Nice done. Nicely done. 1-0, Deborah. Watch the percentages change here. Deborah was a 64% chance going into this race to five. Now that she's won the first game, she's going to be about a 70 or maybe even higher, 75% chance of her winning the match because she won the first game. Now, from what I've seen of C. Perez's game, I don't think it's that far of a reach for her. She's not a 24% favorite. She's more like a, I'd give her a 40-45% chance, personally. Small adjustment to my mic, and maybe to keep some of the background music noise out. And Cease breaks the balls. Guess she made one. We got 4-6. She made a stripe. Yeah, 4-7. Correct. And the stripes are laying pretty good. It's wide open. Nice break. Wide open break. Stop. She's got a great pattern here. She starts with this ball, goes to the ball on the side, which is the 13, stops it, shoots the ball next to the 8 down in the lower corner pocket, follows it just a little, shoots the 9 in the lower corner pocket, comes over for the 10 in the upper corner pocket, gets position for the 11 in the same pocket. She's got a run out. A nice pattern here. 11 ball should be the last shot she shoots, or if she chooses off of the 9 to get on the 11, then the 10. She's probably better off shooting the 10 than the 11 if she can get position on it. It looks like she's drawing the ball to get back for the 10. Or the 11. She's stuck on the 11. She has to shoot the 11. She can't see it. This cue ball's coming down towards this 3 ball on the bottom rail. And she'll either have shape on that or have shape on the 9 or shape on the 10. Or miss the ball and going to give up shape on the 7 ball on the side. 6 ball on the side. Only shot she has. Or the 4 ball in the left-hand corner. Much more difficult shot. The way the balls are laying now, Deborah is faced with a 5 ball that's difficult to get to. But it's not impossible. She can play this ball here, get position for the 4. She's drawn, get position for the 4 or the 1. Never mind. Didn't do either. She can either back cut the 4 or play this ball down, this 3 ball down here. I don't think she can see that. She's standing right in the way, so I can't see what she can do down here. She can't do anything down here. She's going to bank the 4 in the lower right-hand corner. Yeah, Deborah needs to learn to move her cue ball around. I like her shot-making skills. She does a good job with that. She needs to learn to move that cue ball and play to a better angle to the object ball to get on the next object ball. And pretty much forecast the path of the cue ball so she'll have a better angle to the next shot. She's drawing this out. Oh, trouble. She didn't have anything in trouble until she did that. C might, you know, in a case like this, you want to do whatever you can to improve your position on the table. Don't just waste a shot because you don't see what to shoot. She's going to make this ball, and then she's going to have no way to get to the 10 and be at the mercy of Deborah as to what kind of shot she'll get on the 10. You see, she's got no shot at the 10. She might be able to kick it. Yeah, she might be able to kick it off the rail into the corner pocket. And that's exactly what she's looking at right now. And if she makes this, she may get open from the 5. Cue ball might follow up to the rail and down a little bit, depending on the speed. And she may have a shot at the 8 ball. First and foremost, she has to make it to have a shot at the 8. trying to decide which whether it was a good hit or a bad hit. From the way the 10 ball looked, I would have to say that was a bad hit. The 10 ball moved towards the pocket, and it was standing away from the pocket, which means she hit the object ball, the solid ball first, and hit that from behind and went the other way. But they agreed it was a good hit. No one called anything. And if there's a question, it goes to the player, since they didn't call for a ref. Didn't call for a referee, so it goes to the player. Now, Deborah could have called bad hit, and it'd be up to C to agree or disagree. And they both kind of talked about it and agreed it was okay. So she's been handed a gift if she makes this 8 ball. Otherwise, Deborah has 6 balls to run. And the reason I can't say anything is I'm not a referee. I'm just a commentator. Made it. It did turn out to cost her the game. But even if they ask me, I really can't give them an opinion. Let me find out for sure. I can't give them an opinion. Okay, now see, had they asked me if that was a bad hit or a good hit, I cannot give them that answer. It has to be a referee. And Bill Stock is the residing referee. He's here today on hand. He hasn't been called out more than 3 or 4 times that I've seen. The players have handled most of their objections or controversies on their own very amiably, which is, you know, good to see. This is a nice setting. Everyone's been very pleasant, very nice. No problems, no discussions, hard discussions. Deborah leads 1-0. 1-1, excuse me. Deborah's breaking 1-1. It's tied. I was trying to look at the score on the in the back the top of your screen. There's the 2 little 0s you see up there. I was looking over there and thinking she had to put up a score, so she's leading 1-0. But the score is also on your screen next to the players' names. And a dry break again. See, looking things over, she's got an open table. What is she going to take, stripes or solids? Look at the table. Can you see it there? What would you take out there? One ball goes, no problem. Stripes, the 10 ball is tied up. The 13 ball is tied up. The 14 ball is tied up. She's taking stripes, and she's playing the 15 ball by the corner pocket on the left. She's going to be playing... Probably, she can see this ball. I thought that was tied up. Apparently it is not. That's a very nice shot then. She's opening up her problem balls right away. Nice hit. Well done. 12 balls, the next shot by the side pocket. It looks like she's straight into the pocket, so she's going to have a hard time getting shape on the 11. But the 9 ball is up at the top of the table on the top rail. And she can play the 9 ball with a little right English, and she could scratch off the 10 in the side. If she comes down in that direction, if she uses high English, she will come down in that direction. She'll come between about where the 11 ball is, possibly kiss off the 11 and go on the side, or go right into the 10 and go into the side. All depends on how she angles this ball. Looks like she's using just a hair of right. She came right, hits the 5 and goes in the, almost in the drink. not quite to the ditch. Make this and follow. She still has the ball that's tied up. The one goes, but the eight doesn't. Neither does the ten. She strokes the ball pretty pure. She takes her practice strokes. She's got good pre-shot routine. She's got a routine down pretty good. She does about the same thing every time. Gets in the box. She's done with her thinking and gets down to shoot. She's doing her thinking and she's walking around, evaluating. She's been pretty well coached. Look around, find out what you want to do, and don't get down to know what you want to do. That's pretty much it. Once you're down on the ball, the thinking stops. Now I've got to execute. If you're still thinking when you're getting down on the ball, your chances of success are limited by your thinking of something else other than execution. And she's going to bank it. Yeah, she made her call, walked over, got down on the ball, and that's all she's doing. She's not thinking anymore. Very well done. Rather well done. Even though she missed the ball, it was well done. She's going to take out that 10 ball and put it out in the open. And hopefully tie up the one. Let's see how Deborah handles this. Now, can't tell. Well, she's going to have to shoot the ball up by the corner pocket. Or open up this 5-2. Because if she shoots a 5-2, she's got a safety. Leaves nothing. She shoots out. Well, she's got a 3-ball. Now she can come down and get the other ball. So she'll have to contend with the 1-ball. But remember, the 1-ball goes by. Oh, it may not go by the 8. To the corner. And she's left this a little bit too far out, it looks like. Nope, never mind. It's in. I'm mistaken again. I've been using that word quite a bit today. Mistaken, mistaken, mistaken. Is she going to bank this 1-ball? It's not a bad play. It opens it all up. No. She's going to take this shot here. This, even if she misses this, it's good. Never mind. I never saw that cue ball going all the way back up to the top and giving up a shot. C has a shot here. She can use some right low English and come over for this 10-ball and open it up. But she risks, if she hits it on the right side, she risks scratching inside. As you just saw her tap her fingers at the pocket, she knows that if she hits the wrong side of that 10-ball or hits a 10-ball full, she's going in the drink. She could kind of hit just prior to the, well, still going to, yeah, just hit the rail before the 10. But she wants to hit between the 10 and the 1 to get a shot. Realistic to get a shot at the 10. And she did it well. Wow, pretty good try. Nice attempt. Even though she didn't execute it perfectly, she was going for the right shot. That's a lot of it right there. Grounds for improvement. At least you're doing the right things. If you're doing the right things will happen. If you're doing the wrong things, the right things can't happen very often. She says, "What's this? I'll give you ball in hand, but I'm going to tie up your 1-ball. Smart shot. Smart shot. You can have ball in hand, but I'm tying up your 1-ball. Now, the next thing that Deborah can do here is come up, and put the cue ball next to the 1 on the left side, go off the 1, make the 10 in the side, and let the 1-ball block the 8. Force her to kick it, misses it. She's got ball in hand and a run out. Possible run out. Now, a lot of players, that's a little more advanced play than maybe Deborah's used to, but that's precisely what I would do in this situation. Because she's going to end up having to bank the one ball and leave a shot on the eight if she misses. If she banks that one ball, she's moving the eight towards the bottom corner pocket. Now she can't do it. Now she doesn't have the ball in hand anymore. It's possible to do at the left side, but it from, you know, 3.5 feet away, almost 4 feet away, it's extremely difficult to control the speed. She has to hit the, she has to feather the one, pocket the 10, bring the one ball off the rail, right back on top of the cue ball. Wow, what to do here? She's playing the one on the side off of the 10. Great call. Great call. If it would have gone, it was a great call. Now, she just has to stop the ball and play the 8. Don't let the cue ball get on the rail. If the cue ball gets on the rail, she might be blocked on the shot for the 8. And by the angle of this, she hit it perfect. She just stopped it dead. Perfect. She could have easily rocked that cue ball over to the rail and been hooked. Instead, we're going to have a 2-to-1 lead. And watch how these numbers will change. Watch how these numbers change. The percentages will change from this Fargo rating system. They'll change quite a bit. Because this is big for Cease. C. Perez versus Deborah Rogers. Arizona 6s and under singles. Race to 5. 2015. BCAL APL. National warm-ups. For the 39th annual BCAPL National Championships being held in Las Vegas at the Rio, July 22nd through August 1st. Smack 'em and crack 'em. Here we go. This is a good break on the bar, on a 7-foot table. Coming off the center, maybe a little off center, get a little more action on the balls. But she controlled her cue ball well, opened up the rack pretty good. Didn't make a ball. Had she made one, she had good action. The stripes to play. Solids are wide open if that ball goes in the side pocket that she's looking at right now. But the 8 ball doesn't have a home. I guess you could lead to the 8 ball from the 3, which is on the left side of the bottom, lower left hand part of the table. That being your key ball, but she's taking stripes, so that's irrelevant. And she's going to have to look up table for a shot. She doesn't have one down table. Shot I see is the 9 ball, cut on the 9 ball, run into the 4-6, the 4-7 by the side pocket, which will effectively stop her progress. Trouble, trouble, trouble for Deborah. She's trailing 2-to-1. She is now a 46% underdog. I'm sorry, she's a 46% chance of winning. Well, Cease has a 54% chance, so she's a 54% underdog. Nice try. shot on... Oh, she may not have a shot on the six.
She may be locked up here.
He just got put in jail behind a four ball. She's got six balls on the table, seven balls on the table, and she's in jail. Not a good thing. So she's got to put her in jail. She's going to go to the rail and try to put her up against the seven ball. Or the six ball up on top there. Jail. She can make a hit on the nine, but she can't shoot anything other than solid balls. She's surrounded by solid except for the nine ball. She could bank it back to the corner pocket. There's nothing to look at down there, young lady. Except the mess. Got a mess. You got the 11 tied up. You got the 14 tied up. You got the 10 there. It's kind of open. You've got a 12 between two solids. And you've got a 9 ball that can... you can go off the right part of it. Very thin. Come down three rails behind the 11, 9, and play safe. That would be a rather advanced shot. If you're playing that shot, you're probably a 9 or a 10 rated player. That is a foul. Let's see if she calls it. That's... She went two rails beneath and kicked up and never got a rail. No rail, right? Well, this room's filling up. Maybe after this shot, we'll have a right-handed camera view. You can see a lot of the room is filling up with the singles players. About to start at 7 o'clock. Men's singles are trickling in at 32 entries. Looking across the room, I think we're still playing a couple of Scotch double matches. Finals will be at 9. I believe we have Steve Barker and Jessica Perezinski ready to play in the finals of the Scotch doubles. Well, this eight ball goes to the bottom right-hand side. She makes this five ball. She's got to contend with the one. If she stops the ball dead, stops it right there when she makes the five, she'll have a shot off the deuce in the side to break that one ball up open. She'll be able to English the cue ball to come up and clear that one and try to get a shot on it. She went way up. What are you going to do with the one ball, young lady? Making a ball is one thing, finishing it off is another. Keep in mind as you're watching, these are six-rated players. And the ratings go from 5 to 10. She says, you can't run out as long as they've got that one ball on top of your nine. Problem is, she can't play safe off the nine and bring the cue ball down below these balls. I don't think she is aware of that, but I'm not sure. We'll find out. She pockets balls well. Hit that fool. There you go. Shot on the 10. Follow it. Whoa. Shot on the 10. Follow it first. Shot on the 14 in the side, and then a shot on the 12. That'd be your more logical pattern. Although, if she can, she could stop the ball. And that's what she's going to attempt to do. It's going to run up on it a little bit. Those are tough shots. And she's played safe. Rail first here. She'll go rail first just before the side pocket and try to push the two ball up to the corner pocket. This is actually a makeable shot. Just going into the rail first, coming off and catching about where that white is on the ball, as you can see. And that'll send it to the pocket. A little bit more. A little bit. She's close. She's calling into the corner. Shot looks pretty close. She's coming. She looks like she's going to be able to make this ball. She's lining up real nice. I can see the lineup, and it looks really close. Really close. No, she's just changed it. She's gone in too deep. Perfect. Perfect, perfect. Looks like she's gone in too deep. But this is a 7-foot table. These are diamonds, and the rails do grab. So there's no slide there. And it grabbed nice and came out nice. She's going to bank this one ball to the lower right-hand corner pocket. And should have a shot on the 8 if she makes it. It looks like it may clear that 9 ball. I'm not sure. Really can't tell. I don't think it does. She's using the wrong English. Oh, no, she's not. Now she's moved back to a better English. She's going to double kiss this ball, looks like, from the way she's aiming it. From what I see on the monitor. Oh, okay. I thought she was banking it. She wasn't. She was playing safe all the way. So that double kiss was on. And she's left her opponent a very difficult shot, but she's going to be faced with the same situation. What to do with the one ball? How do I open it up? How do I get a shot on the one ball? That's all she's thinking of, is how do I get a shot on the one ball? Can I keep the 9 ball tied up with the 1 ball and then get it when she has to move it? Who's going to get bored first? Cutting the 10 ball. Just playing said no rail. Ouch. Now, C has a great shot here. She can put the ball to the 4. She can just pocket the 9 ball for her if she has to. Or she can put the ball on the right side of the 1, bank it down towards the 8, and stop the cue ball right on top of the 9. If she makes the 9 for her, she's golden. And then just push the ball towards the pocket. Don't let it sit outside where the 9 ball is now. Hit it hard enough to push the ball towards the pocket. Now, that's not going to do any good, because now she's just going to roll up on the 10 ball and leave you with a tough hit. She's looking to see where she has to be. Hits the right side of the 10 ball. And with speed to the rail, and she'll hook her with the 8. It is a fairly easy hit, going to the rail on the right or going to the rail on the left. Rail on the right is easier. She's called a safety. This looks good. And now you see the rail. She hits a second diamond from the corner pocket. She'll hit that ball. I just roll up on. Oh. She has to put this in play. Otherwise, she's going to give up another shot and another shot if she doesn't run out the first time. She's going to want to hit this to put it in play. Don't just leave it on the rail. Don't just make the hit. Yes, you're going to leave your opponent a low percentage shot by leaving her on the rail, but you're not going to have anything if they don't pocket the ball. This will make a hit. Oh, no hit. I am so surprised. I'm so surprised. And I think that was caused because it was a very slow roll. The slower you hit a rail, the less angle it will create coming off of it. It'll almost slide off of it, which is what that did. A little harder, the rail grabs it, and you maintain the angle going in that you have going in coming out. If you hit it slower, you lessen the angle coming out. This will tie us up at 2 if she can get out here. from what I've seen of Deborah, she's going to stop the ball and play it in the side. Regardless, if she plays the ball on the side with pocket speed, she's not leaving the shot. She's leaving a very low percentage bank shot. So basically, this is a free shot. Free shot to win. Oh, she's calling in the corner. It's the same difference. I mean, as far as a free shot, it's the same. The cue ball will probably be on the right side of the table. She's afraid of giving her a closer shot at the one ball is what it is. She says, if I miss it, she'll have a shot. But she made this ball. 2-2. And I believe Deborah started breaking, so it's her break. Two games to two. Now, the percentages have changed. We got a 61% chance of Deborah win. This is about the same difference in percentages at the start of the game, because instead of a race to five, now we have a race to three. So your percentages should be pretty close to what they started. Since it's a shorter race, I believe it might favor the underrated player, lower rated player. Because I believe when we first started, the percentages were 63 to 26. Or 36. I thought D was maybe, C was in the 20s. I don't really recall what the percentages were, but they were pretty low for her. A lot lower than I thought. Deborah's breaking the balls, two games apiece. So lock yourself up. Combo on the 15 ball in the side pocket off the 11. I'm wondering if she can see this 13 ball. It's down by the lower left-hand corner. And she says, I don't care if I can see the 13. I'm still playing this combo. You're up in the booth, I'm down on the table. I'm shooting, you're talking. I know what I'm doing, you're thinking, you know what I'm doing. I just got put in my place, didn't I? Good. Hope you enjoyed that, I did. She's walking around with a little bit of confidence. Body language denotes some confidence. And intention. This game could be over. If she can roll this cue ball and lay it right where the 13 is now, that high from the rail, and then follow with left high English, she can get on that 10 ball and then get on the 8 in the side and take the third game. Take it for a 3-2 lead. It would be the fifth game. cutting this ball. Well done. Bounce out of there. Now, see right there? That's a great shot. No reward. But you have to understand that when you're shooting shots like that, you've got to know where that cue ball is coming off. And if you don't want to hit a ball, use English to avoid it. I think she had her hands full just making that ball. She's going to roll up behind the one and leave her safe. Try to push that ball up where you have a shot next time, where you left a shot. Well, the two ball goes to the side, and if that can happen, well, then we've got action because she can follow it for the three in the lower left-hand corner. A combo on that 6-4 that's on the rail by the side pocket on the right. It's not completely on, but there's enough space between the balls that she can make it. It's makeable, and she has to open it up. Play the one ball first. And for her next shot, for an encore, she's going to play the seven ball down by the corner pocket, 6 feet away. Now for the five. Come down for the 2-3. Possibly, if you can put a little low English, come towards that 6-4 and open it up. Interesting. She's looking to shoot these balls first. I'm going to go ahead and play safe here. I'm going to push the five, bounce the five ball to about between the left-hand corner pocket and the middle of the table. It's going to bounce it off that rail towards the pocket. Leave the cue ball froze where they can't make the 13 by the corner. And only shot available is cutting the nine ball. She's playing the ball. Where will the cue ball go? Towards the balls, 0-1 over, she's tied it up. Okay, so she has those balls tied up. I would recommend going off the four ball towards the left-hand side of the upper table and leaving the cue ball on the head rail, bouncing off the rail to a diamond from the right-hand corner pocket. Opens those two balls up. No shot, a bank shot on the 9, nothing on the 11, on the 13. Don't play this ball. Leave that ball there for breaking that ball up. Don't play this ball. Wow. Deborah, when you watch this match, move balls with a purpose, an intended purpose. Make them serve your purpose, not your opponent's. She just double-kissed this 11 ball in front of the hole. 13 ball. Whatever ball's on the right by the 3 ball, if she goes into it with high English, she'll push the 3 ball out of the way, push the ball in front of the hole, and stay right there. They'll double-kiss the cue ball, hit the 3 ball, stay there, and probably not leave it. She'll leave the 2 ball on the side regardless. But with the 6-4 tied up, even though it can go, I don't think Deborah would make it. It's possible, though. But that would be my recommendation. Harder, harder. You have to move the 3 ball out of the way because you can't get safe on the 2. Harder, you're still safe on the 1. But you may open up your 13. Now she's going to have to do that same shot again. The good thing about it is, if the 2 ball is off to the right of where it is now, more than likely she'll be able to play the same shot and have a safety again. Now she's forced to bank the six ball to the side pocket. And I don't know if she can get the cue ball out of the way to avoid the double kiss. I don't think she can. And once again, I'm glad to say I was incorrect. Now, she is faced with a dilemma. The shot I suggested earlier is null and void because of the six ball being in the jaws of the side pocket. So she's going off this ball to try to get behind the eight and three. And there's a pocket there. So her speed has to be perfect. And it is. She's left a shot on the three ball. Left with a perfect shot on the three ball. All she has to do is come across the right side of it, pocket the ball, come out for the six, then the four, and the eight ball's dead in the corner pocket. She unintentionally, playing a good shot, gave away the game. And here comes Bill Stock to save the day. She's in no danger of doing anything wrong here. No danger at all. All she has to do is come to the right side of the ball. Very clean, very well done. Now, she wants to shoot the six ball here in the side first. But actually, with the angle that she's gotten, she should shoot the four ball. Because this ball's going to drive low, and she may have to bank the four unless her speed's perfect. She's down pretty low. It cuts in. Cuts in. Here we go. This is to take a 3-2 lead. Made the ball. Now we'll see how these percentages change with the Fargo rating system. Three to two, Deborah takes the lead. You know, one of the things about watching the men play and the women play, the women take a 3-2 lead. They don't show all this anger and frustration, and most of them don't show the anger and frustration. That happens in a lot of the men matches, and you have one grump and one not so grump. Or one grump and one happy, in most cases. In my case, I'm the grump. But I will say, I attempt not to show it. Attempt not to show it. Come on, guys, let's pick it up. Let's do something exciting. I feel like I'm getting boring for you guys. Somebody yell at me or something. Of course, I can't hear you, so you can have to yell real loud. But come down to the casino and yell at me from the back of the booth, back there where that you see that 2-3 where the score is. Go up there and, you know, cuss me out or something. Let's get something happening. Break and cue ball in the corner pocket. Hit some balls and was herded right down to the corner pocket. Well, she's got an open table. What do you do with an open table? Select the balls you feel you can handle better than your opponent can. What is the easiest layout? What has the best layout where I can run balls and open up my problem balls? Problem ball should be taken care of early. She should have come down for this 14 and moved the 12. We've got in shape on the 12 for the lower right-hand pocket. The 12 is in that four-ball cluster with the 8. As she started with that, she'd be looking at a runout. She started with something else, and now she has to find a way to get shape for that 12 ball for that area. She has to be able to lay the cue ball in about a 6-inch circle for a shot of the 12. And she's going to need a ball to lead her to that. She doesn't have it. I take it back. She does have it once she makes the 14. She doesn't make the 12 first. 14 is on the bottom rail in the center of the table. The 12 is by the corner pocket. Okay, now she's going to pocket that. Now she's going if she pockets the ball by the corner pocket first and brings the cue ball down just off the rail, she'll be able to pocket the ball in the middle of the table on the bottom rail, follow it for shape on the 12, to bump into the 12 if she gives herself the right angle to do that. She has to give herself the right angle. Deborah, you can do this. Figure it out, sweetie. You gotta be able to get that 12 ball in play. There you go. That ball goes there. From that ball, you want the cue ball to come off. No. Well, this could work if she knows how to move the cue ball for the 12 for the 14. Big problem is she's gonna have to now go rail first. She cannot. Nice angle, Steve. Thank you. I thought, see, from the angle I was looking at it before he moved that, before that camera adjustment, I thought she could go to the rail and possibly make the ball by the corner pocket and come two rails for that 12. But no, the four ball is way too far up. If anything, she can come underneath the 12 and kick the rail on the bottom and push the 12 up rail a little bit and call it a safety. She's trying to go rail first or straight at it? She might have room to go. I don't think she had room to go straight at it. And she didn't. Well, she might have had room. She just didn't hit the ball on the right side to make it. This is a toughie, guys. As you can see, the percentages. Now that Deborah is 3-2 in a race to 5, the percentages of Deborah winning are 77% with C percentages of 23% on that Fargo rating system. But this room's come to life. Steve, can I get that right-hand angle again? Now you can see some players in the background along with the shot she's shooting for the side pocket. Nice shot. Thank you. Perfect. she can't see the four, but she has a seven in the side, which opens up the 8-3. Yes, the seven goes on the side. You're not going to hit it that hard. She's concerned about making the eight ball in the side pocket, and she should not be. It'll go straight up by the five on the right, to the right side of the five when she pockets this ball. Not too hard. Just in case I'm wrong. I don't want to say I was mistaken and you lose the game on it. Of course, she can't hear me, I hope. Well, C is in danger of going down two games, 4-2. You'll see the percentages go to about 93 or 94%. She'll be a 6 or 7% underdog. Has a nice angle on this 14 to come up to the side pocket. Speed is critical here if she goes that route because she has to be between the 4 and the 7 ball.
One more reminder.
And she got right behind the 4. That's where speed is critical. Little High English would have taken her to the second rail on the side. And she could have used that to kill the ball and hit it a little harder so she doesn't go by and hit the 6 ball or the 7 ball too. So use the rails to control your cue ball. Coming straight up is amateurish. Using both rails is a more experienced player. An experienced player will take a cue ball, two rails, into the line of position instead of one rail across the line of position. And by line of position, I mean the line to make the A ball to the side pocket, which would be where the 7 ball is. That's where you want to be ideally. That's your line. So you want to have the cue ball traveling off of a rail somewhere in that line, parallel to that line or on that line. Give you a good shot on the 8 ball in the side pocket, or she could have drawn it and played the 8 ball in the corner pocket. And she'll give up ball in hand, but C needs to run 6 balls. That is the challenge. The right side is they're all in the middle of the table. They're not isolated. They're not off to the side. If she develops a good pattern, one ball leads to the next. And you have easy shots all the way around. For example, if she starts with the 2 ball in the corner pocket, then the 1 ball in the upper right-hand corner pocket, and the 5 in the side, stopping each ball right where the ball is, the 5 in the side, then the 7 in the side, the 4 in the corner, or the 3 in the, she's starting reversed. That should be one of the last balls she takes. Unless she can get back up to the 2 and then go the same route. And use the 4 ball for a key shot. Now she takes the 2, the 1, the 5, the 6, and the 4. They're all stop shots. This is not. She has to run the cue ball around, and she's going to go play shape on the ball in the side pocket. Which means if she doesn't get a good angle, she's going to have to run the cue ball to the next angle. And means speed's involved, angle's involved, rails may be involved, instead of just a stop. Let the ball, let the star pattern lead you to where you have to go. Still works here. She can still make it work now. She can recover here. She can just kind of draw this ball a hair, get on the 2, shoot it in the side, stop it for the 4, or pocket the deuce, try to keep the cue ball in the same area as the two ball is now, so you can pocket the four and stop it, or just slide down a little bit or draw it a little bit for a shape on the eight. So many variables. An inch difference of where you want to be, where it is, can make all the difference in the world. She's perfect. She makes this two ball and stops the cue ball there, and then she just makes the four ball and stops the four ball. Or can stun it over to the right for a perfect shot on the eight. Perfect. She hit that ball very nice. And as you know, she hit it firm. She just wants to stop this ball or just fall forward the slightest bit. That's not going in. Ouch. Ouch. She's got a little bit of a cut on this eight ball. It's not a hard shot. It's not an easy shot. She does have to be concerned where a cue ball is headed. The cue ball is going to head to the, it's going to hit the bottom rail and bounce towards that side pocket. So she's going to have to be concerned about that. She's just concerned about making the ball. Now, the reason she didn't come very close to that side pocket was, first of all, speed. Second of all, she hit too much ball, which killed her speed and changed the angle that it would have come off towards the side. Now, she's the controller of her own destiny. Soft shot, and have that cue ball leave the rail going towards the four ball underneath the spot, so she can play it in the side very softly, everything very softly. Too hard, and she's very fortunate she just went by that ball, and she was playing that. She may have been playing that, to play it in the corner instead of the side. She may have been playing that. This will tie it up at three. If she makes this, she has the eight. Just don't slide down and make the eight. She looks like she's in a little thick, but let's see. Yeah, I thought so. You could tell by the way she was aiming that she was hitting a little thick or too much ball, and she wasn't cutting the ball enough. And the way she hit that, had she cut the ball enough, she may have made the eight. Well, this ball's close to the rail, so it could catch the rail and stay up. If not, it's going to be a 4-2 lead for Deborah. Well, she has a big shot ahead of her. 5.5 feet away. And all she has to do is make it. And, of course, not follow the eight ball in. But all she has to do is make this shot. She makes balls pretty well, so I'm going to say she makes this and wins the game. Let's see how right I am. See what percentages I have. Oh, look who's wrong. Again. I watched this young lady play a game last night that was probably the best end of an eight ball game you could see. Last six shots were all to me. Everyone was a great shot by both, all four players involved in the Scotch doubles. Now just don't follow it in. Hit the rail and the ball at the same time. There you go. 4-2. Watch these percentages change when he enters the score. My, my, my. I think this will probably put Deborah at about 94%. It's going to be a huge jump. 91. I was off by three. Sorry, guys. 91% to 9%. Keep in mind, we're in Tucson, Arizona, warming up for the 39th annual BCAPL National Championships, playing for $800,000 in prize money. Upcoming September 3rd through the 7th, 2015 Southwest Regional at the Casino of Fort McDowell. And U.S. Open 8 ball, U.S. Open 10 ball. The pros will be in Vegas, same time you're there for the national championships, July 24th through the 31st. These are Moscone Cup points. This will get you points to get on the Moscone Cup. Pros that are looking to get on there, you got to play those events and do well to get those points. You gotta place. You gotta be there for those points. 4-2 lead. Deborah Rogers over C. Perez. Race to 5. AZ singles. 6 and under singles. Breaks the ball. I don't think Deborah's made a ball in the break yet. Probably her third or fourth break. Probably her fourth break. She's yet to make a ball. Well, this is the seventh game, so I think she started breaking, so that would be her fourth break. She has one ball she can shoot at, and she just called it right out there. She said, 10 ball. No hesitation. She says, I'm firing this ball, and we'll see what happens. Well done. Opened everything up except the 8. Everything has a hole now. She can actually stop this ball and play the 9 in the upper corner pocket, just like she's, that's what she's looking at. Come up for the 11 in the corner, 13 in the side, 15 ball in the corner, and something with the 8. She's got to do something with the 8 because it does not have a home. Got to find it a home. Some place to put that 8 ball away. She did that very nice. I like the way she did that. She's kind of stunned the ball for shape. Knows her spot, did what she had to do. It's left out just a, ooh, it went in. I thought she left it out just a hair. I thought it was going to catch the point of that pocket and stay up. And once again, I was incorrect. There's one person in particular who likes to hear me when I'm commentating on some of the pool matches that he's heard me commentate. He loves it when I'm incorrect. He says, I'm always right. I always try to be right. He loves to tell me when I'm incorrect. So I've made it a point to point out my mistakes just for him if he's listening. Not going to be able to start the men's singles match at 7 o'clock. But since it is a master player and an advanced player playing, we don't think it'll take an hour to play races 7 and 6. So whatever time this match is over, we'll still have the Scotch doubles match scheduled at 9 o'clock, and we will more than likely be timely with that match. But we'll bring them to you as fast as we can now, since this match is supposed to start at 7. The men's singles match is supposed to start at 7. They've already started the matches on the side there in the room, except for this table. We got one match coming up. You've got Steve Lillis and Trace Kane coming up to play on this table. Looking for a very good match for you guys. You'll see some outstanding play from both players. Trace is on fire. He's a player out of Phoenix, Arizona. Steve Lillis, I do not know, but being a master player, I'm going to say he plays pretty good. Pretty darn good. I mean, anybody can give Trace a game on the wire, it's got to play pretty darn good. Drop? It does. If C is able to come back to the table, how will she get to the eight ball? How can she get to the eight ball? How can she get back to the table? Just like this, with ball in hand. All righty. Here's what I'm doing. I'm taking the cue ball, putting it in the center of the table, playing the 13 in the side, coming down and bumping the 8, shooting the 14, coming back down and making the 8 ball. The 8 ball has to be moved if she wants to win this game. And that's the angle that leads you to it. Don't touch the 4. Go right into the 8 softly. Otherwise, you end up behind the 4 or the deuce. Or behind the 8 if you go into the 4. And you won't see that ball that you need up in that corner pocket. Come on, bounce out. It did. I think it's enough. Let's look at her body language. No, it's not enough. Nice camera, Steve. It may be enough. She may be able to cheat the pocket to the lower left side of the pocket. If anything, she'll be able to lay the cue ball there. She wants to get as close as she can to the 8 ball. Don't want to be wild with the strong catch the rail. Don't catch the rail, you'll lose it. Well done. And if she can make it, she's got a straight shot. She's got half. She's got 3/4. She's got half a pocket to play with. She's got about 2 1/4 inches of pocket to make this. Which is the size of the ball, so she's got enough to make it. There she, oh, don't follow it in. Oh, stop, it did. Whoa. Did you guys have your brakes on at home? I did. Stop that cue ball, we want more pool. Wow. Well, percentage just changed. Alrighty, she's breaking the balls. 3 to 4. Fading 3 to 4 in the race to 5. She's showing she can do it. She's showing she can do it. Let's see if she does it. She's got to win this game for sure. There's no tomorrow. No tomorrow. Today is all we have. That's what this game is to her. Everything is open. I'm looking at playing the 4 ball, then the 1, then the 3. The 2, the 5, and the 8. 4 balls on the right. One ball's on the left, but so she's looking at playing now. I don't like if she plays that now. Although she can't play that now. Roll it softly. Push the 13 down. It stops her for the three. But the angle she's going to get off of that is not going to lead her well to the four. She's going to have to do something to create the angle to get to the four. She could kind of go in a little hard to this. And, well, now she's in a little bit of trouble. Because she'll play the four, and her angle does not lead her to the five. The two, excuse me. The angle won't lead her to the five, I don't think, unless she follows it perfectly straight. See? She had just a little bit of an angle that didn't let her come down to fall on that five just right. So now, what she'll want to do is play the four, stop it, and then play the three ball and come straight down on the line between the cue ball where it is now and the three ball and come on down and get on that five in that vicinity. Interesting. You know, the sad part is you really, it would be hard to teach a player patterns. Because you have to learn shot selection on your own, because there's so many variations, and different people will look at it differently. This could work for her. She could make this ball go off the 10, go two rails, maybe not scratch, go two rails and get on the 4, then the 3, and then the 8. This could work very well for her. Kind of like that. And it will work. Again, she wants to play the four ball first. Stop it there. Angle to come down for the 8. But earlier in the broadcast, I mentioned something about using two rails to lead to the line of the position. Now she's created a monster. And the monster is not big enough to get down for the 8 ball. She can't eat the 4 ball up and get down for the 8, I don't think. I hope she proves me wrong. She has to go forward with English, which probably hits the 13. If it does, well, it might send her down. It did send her down. There you go. Very well done. She proved me wrong. But I was looking at the fact that she could come off that 13. That was awesome. Well done. And we'll have a tie ball game if she makes this ball. And we do. 4-4. How are those percentages looking now? We'll probably go back to about 60-40. Now it's a race to 1. Let's see what the percentages do here. Interesting how this rating system works. 56-44. That's pretty close. Pretty close. It's a race to 1. 1 game. 1 error, 1 shot, 1 good roll can make the difference in this game. 1 mistake. 1 fortunate roll. So many variables. Just 1 outcome. 1 winner, 1 loser. Going back to some old commercials that I used to watch. The agony of defeat. You can forget the skier coming off of that. Getting hurt the way it did for that commercial. Well, it wasn't the commercial. They viewed it, and they used it as part of the commercial. She made a ball and a break. That's probably her 5th break. This is the ninth game. This is her fifth break. Because she started breaking. That's the first ball she made on the break. Three in the corner. Jen. Two in the corner. Unless the 10 ball got her. Yeah. Forget the corner. She's playing the 6-7 on the side. Well done, two on the side. Or, actually a better way to get to this would be the four, then the one, then the two, then the five. Four would go in the bottom right-hand corner, the one in the left corner, the two on the side, the five in the upper corner. It's all very doable, it's laying real nice. Although I will say she can actually get there the same way if she shoots the two ball first, bumps the 11, makes sure she has a shot on the 5, is able to come down a little bit for a shot on the 4, then the 1, then the 8. So it can be done. Different ways, different pattern. But I like what she's doing here. I like it more than gambling on a bump on the 11. Now she's forced to shoot the right shot that leads her to the two ball. No, you don't want to shoot this. She's looking to shoot the two ball in the corner. You shoot the two ball on the side and then come up for the 5. Try to get the angle where you're straight in almost. She's grudgingly shooting the right shot. Oh, nice. Well done. Well done. See how nice it leads to this? There you go. Now, if she hits this with a little... It could be trouble. It could slide right by the 5 and have to shoot it in the corner. But she's going to move that ball, and that ball stops it, and she's dead in. What a nice run. What a nice run. Now there's still the 6 ball that's right next to that 11. What to do with that guy? I don't think he goes by the 8 to the corner. Irrelevant. We'll never know. Steve, can you give me a right shot? Right angle, so I can see if the 5 ball passes the 8. The 6 ball passes the 8. The other way. No, okay, thanks. Perfect. Had she made the 5 ball, she did not have a shot on the 6. She'd have to bank it. She's got to come back for this, for those balls on the right side. Well, that's called a safety. Fortuitous miss. Or a safety. Well, I can't wait to get that men's singles match in here. Show you guys some really good pool. You're watching some pool here. But we'll show you some top level Arizona pool. These ladies are struggling, doing a good job, doing their best. And doing some very, very good things. Especially at the level they play at. And their level is nothing to sneeze at. They're 6 rated players. and some are under 6. So, but we watch them miss them. What good players would call easy shots. We watch them miss some easy patterns. Nice, nice. See, just little things like that that you see. The way she struck the ball was nice and clean, a little crisp actually, with a little bit of draw. Came over. She can shoot the 10 ball. I don't think it'll go, but as long as she kind of holds it up to the on the same line where she's at, doesn't come down table, she won't give up a shot on the 6. She wants to open those balls up. Well, I don't understand why she's going over there. She can open these balls up two ways. Hit the bottom side of the 10, not scratch, and leave her beneath by the corner pocket, leaving the 8 ball between the cue ball and the 6. Long shot on the 5. Or just let her see the 6. Not make it, but let her see it. But it can be played off the ball, so. She might just push this down in front of the pocket and go right back to the same side she's on. Or is she banking it? Oh, she's played her safe all the way. All she's going to get is distance. I would go ahead and bump that 5 ball in front of the corner pocket and let her have her shots. Now against a good player, or a very good player, you can't do that because they'll run out on you. But at this level, when they're evenly matched in skills, play your opponent's skills. Looks like she's going to try to make it. She did call it. I would just bump it and leave the cue ball froze. Bump it off the rail so it goes to your pocket. And she missed the whole ball. And, to add insult to injury, gave her ball in hand, broke up the 2 balls that were tied up. If she starts with the 11 ball to the side pocket, this game could be over. The 11 ball is the bottom ball, the red ball, in that cluster of 3 in the middle of the table. That opens up the entire table for her. No problems, no maneuvering. It can be a stop-stop, and she sees that. There you go. She recognizes it. That's awesome. That's when players can recognize things like that, you know that they've had some coaching, number one. Number two, there's promise. There can be improvement because they see the problems and they're addressing them when they have to, immediately. Let's follow this up. Stay with the stroke. Nice and easy. Nice and easy. She can either play the 14 and then come back up for the 9 or play the 9. But it's got a steeper angle than she'd like to have because she'd like to hold it for the 9. But she can hit it with left English and come around for the 10, 2 rails, maybe even 3. Oh, she's down behind the 8. She's got nothing. You had to hit that and come around. Use that bottom rail, go to the side rail, come off of it, and play the 10 or the 11, whichever it lies. But the weakest thing you could do is exactly what she did. She hit that ball weak. Oh, that could lead to a scratch on the side. even though I don't think she can hit it full enough, but it could lead to a scratch on the side. It won't. She makes this ball. It should not scratch. Might scratch in the same corner she's going to, but it's not going to scratch on the side, I don't think. Unless she hits it too full. Well, guess what? Unwittingly, she played safe. Deborah can just kick it. She can just kick at the five ball. Kick at the five ball. Nice. Two reasons to kick at this ball. First and foremost, it's too easy to play safe on, so you don't want to leave it as your last ball when your opponent has three balls down table from you. Number two, if she happens to make it, she will have a shot on the six. Even though there's a possible scratch in the corner pocket, she will have a shot on the six, which she can follow down and play safe behind the eight again. And number seven, it did not work out for her, really. She hit the ball, but she didn't push it over in front of the pocket. She still has a ball that's kind of easy to play safe on. Not as easy, but easy. Just have to play it closer to the side rail on the right. If you leave the cue ball, it has to be left closer to the side rail. I would play this, play that ball. Play that ball in the corner, the one she's looking at now. Come straight down, you'll have either the 12 or the 10. Side or corner. You know, she can hit these balls pretty crisp sometimes. It's pretty nice. Now she's got them both to the corner. Just don't scratch on the side when you stun this ball. A little bit of low English. Perfect, perfect camera angle. We get to see exactly what the player's at, looking at, how she's aiming. See where if she draws this ball, it can lead into the side pocket. Yes, she just saw that. She's looking to follow the ball with high English. If she hits a crisp, she should go up about two diamonds and be straight into the side pocket. She's cutting it back to the other side. Scratch possibility to the side. Definite scratch possibility on the side, cutting that ball to the corner. Changed her mind. She's using draw. I like this shot the best. Just a little stun. Catch the rail about 2 inches short of the side pocket. Come off of it just a little bit, and you're straight into the corner pocket on the left. Or you can come off it a lot of bit and straight into the corner pocket on the right. Takes a little more finesse to pull that shot off. She likes to shoot softer than that, so don't force it. Although she does, she has hit some balls pretty crisp. Yeah, she's afraid of the side pocket, and she's also afraid of that side pocket. What to do? Decisions, decisions. You know the draw prevents you from scratching. Use it. There you go. There you go. As soon as this game's over, we'll bring you the men's singles match. Steve Lillis versus Trace Kane. Steve will go to 7 games. Trace will go to 6. We have a master playing an advanced player. Well, she's missed the ball, but she has left her opponent in a precarious position. She's froze against the rail by the side pocket with a, I don't want to say funky angle for the 6. And pretty much a bank angle on the 5. If she makes the 5, the best she can do is give herself a steep cut for the corner pocket in the right. The worst she can do is miss the ball. Look And right down at the shot. Made it. Drained. Ooh, it. Oh, that table looked like it kind of fell over to the side a little bit. Didn't it? Did it look like it kind of came over just a little bit? Just a hair. It might have just come over a hair. A lot of that's the nap of the cloth. Maybe a little chalk down there. But she hit it really, really soft. She held the angle pretty good on the five. She doesn't have a bad shot. She had the best shot she could have on the five. Now, see, she leads into a shot here. But she's looking at it. She's straight into the side pocket. She follows it. She might fall straight into the side. And she can't really draw it to change it. When you leave yourself straight in, you can either go forward or backwards. You can't go to the sides unless you cheat the pocket. Cheating the pocket means you're making it smaller and easier to miss. Because you're aiming to a side of the pocket instead of the center of the pocket. And the eight ball is blocked by the six. But she can make it. Go ahead and make the six with the eight, leaving a bank on the five, and gamble that your opponent doesn't make it. Oh, she's going to cut it. Cutting this ball can lead to a scratch in the upper right-hand corner pocket. Unless she gives us some English. If she makes the ball, the line is to the corner pocket in the upper right-hand corner. Although the angle may be, it looks like it's right on. Remember, this comes short, so it may come about 6 inches short. If she hits it perfect. She's got just a hair spin on the right side. That'll probably leave her a diamond short if she makes the ball. She's got to cut it. She's got to cut it thin. Thin to win. Thin she did. Not off the five. Oh, gosh. What a fantastic shot. Oh, but she's hung it up. The problem that Deborah is faced with is getting the cue ball up for a good shot or an easy shot on the five. Hit the right side of the six ball and go straight back up. Wow, I thought she made the ball. In fact, I thought it was drained. Look at this. Is it trouble or is it perfect? It's perfect. It's perfect. My, my, what a shot she made. What a shot she made. Corner pocket. She has to, don't double hit this. I'm the opponent. I'm watching for a double hit here. Praying, but she didn't. It's perfect. Absolutely perfect. Oh, my. Look how deep the eight ball is in that pocket. It is so deep. What a fantastic game. How about a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen?